Okay, jumping in quickly on this one, because I already did one and this kid's getting crazier. All right. Okay, so the message that's coming to me right before I hops on here is that one of the tests that we have and probably continue to have because of the world that we're living in is that do we allow the distractions that are essentially tests to keep pulling us away from our path? We have the star reverse. We had that one in the previous read as well. And this one's giving me that you can't find your light. Of course, it's there, but you're struggling to see it or you're struggling to see yourself. Judgment is out here, clarified by the King of Wands reversed. So I am just okay. They're telling me to say you can't fake the funk. I might have to get another one on that one. Okay, we'll come back to that if I get anything else on it. We do have some pages out here, so you might be feeling like you're in that energy. It is a we do have two, so that's 11-11. That's manifestation energy. You may be in the Six of Pentacles. Which could also be a note to give. In order to balance things out, or to even just be compassionate or generous with the people around you, it doesn't have to be monetary. We have the Knight of Pentacles reversed. Such a crazy mix. Okay. There's a feminine here that's standing in her power. She's in this Nine of Pentacles energy. Ten of Cups is your wish fulfillment. We have the Fool reversed. So there's been some, you're feeling reckless. There's been some recklessness, or you didn't take a leap of faith. You're scared to take a leap of faith. Queen of Swords. You might draw a couple more clarifiers. All right. Well, why this spirit? Why this Knight of Pentacles reversed? Why is this up here? And what is this Nine of Pentacles? What is this Nine of Pentacles reversed? Might be a lack of stability or direction. That's what I'm getting, lack of direction. So you might need to go, you might need to be in hermit mode. Okay, I'll tell you the top one. Two of Swords reversed. World on the bottom. Ten of Pentacles on the bottom. Yeah, you're struggling with decisions, struggling with what choice to make. So that's a reminder of trust your discernment. We don't have any High Priestess or Moon energy out here. Yeah, trust your discernment. You're the master choice maker. You're the master of your reality. So, I mean, if judgment's been called, it is what it is. You can get back yourself back up, get back on that horse and ride, or get back up to that and sitting back on your throne. This is a very sassy read, y'all. This is not this is just what they're giving me to. Because it is life is about choices, and so that last one was about like had we had Wheel of Fortune, so and Two of Wands, so it's like focus in on what you want. Like, and I think I mentioned I'm gonna say that in this one about the distractions, like even with like family, like it's like you realize more and more it's like it's just you and God, you know, like I have Teddy with me and. So he's always going to be, as long as he needs me, he'll be a part of the decisions, but it's still me and God making, figuring things out. So to be able to be this, to stay stable, to stay up. And it's hard. We live in a world of distractions. We live in a world that that's created this idea that we need everybody around us and that we're supposed to. And I just think that's how humans are. I think we just want to look out at the outside and like, or like it, talk to somebody and like get them to, what's the word? Like how it's easier. It's less responsibility to have to like for someone else to make some decisions for you. And I have a lot to learn on delegating. So, but I will say that, being in hermit mode and speaking to God does give you a sense of like emotional stability and well-being that I've never experienced outside of that. So, don't be afraid to sit with yourself and be in solitude if you need to. It's a very like message that Queen of Swords, feeling her. Okay. You got it though. You're the master of your reality.